last 100-odd years. Maybe they'll say, right, we have to do something about it, and they will. I don't know. You know, it's hard to say.
What, have you got a title for the book yet, Robert?
Yeah, it's just simply called Orange. And probably because it's probably the best way. You know, it's probably confused a few people, but yeah, it's just called Orange. It's got a subtitle, but I can't remember what the subtitle is, to be honest with you.
Right, before we come to the end of this interview, is there anything a person in the street can do to put pressure on industry and the US government concerning the debacle in Vietnam?
The one thing that communities have learned over the last number of years, last decades or whatever, the best way to fight the big corporations, the best way to fight the state, the best way to fight anyone is to make them spend money and make them lose money. And that's the biggest weapon. So if you're in the street, you know, you could go to the extremes and stop buying your favorite Pink album and do that. But then I wouldn't particularly pick on her because her father was actually in Vietnam, and she gives concerts in America where the money is donated to the various veterans associations. So you know, you can't be running around boycotting people just because you think, okay, they're in America, let's have a go at them. You know, the best way is that I would do if I was not in America. I would just not go on holiday, and if I was in America, I would then start thinking about other ways. I would support people like Pink because of her stand, and I would support more and more of the people who actually stand up. You should tell every single American you bump into them what you think of their administration and what you think of their government and what you think of their history. And if they get annoyed about it, like Christy Moore, an Irish singer, was singing a song there that was by, actually not by him, but it was by an English singer of Irish descent called Morrissey, and he has a song where he criticizes the American, and this woman came up after the concert and started giving out to Christy Moore because he sang the song, and she was insulted. People think that because they're individuals, they don't have any power and they can't do anything, and sometimes when you're in a big crowd and there's a mob coming down on top of you, that you're going, what am I going to do here? But you know, people are much stronger. And I've discovered through what the guts of 4 decades covering communities. Communities, individuals, community families can do amazing things. And people are amazing anyway. But at some stage we have to start standing up to the institutions, to the whole system of the way our governments work, the fact that they're not accountable. So, just get up and bollocks, ask questions, you know, and just be contrary, and just if you find something out, tell everyone what you found out. They can argue with you, they can jump up and down and say you're wrong, but you know, you start a debate. I don't know, probably.
Yeah. Okay, mate. Just about run out of time here. Is there anything else you want to say? Any other books you want to plug, or any websites you want to point people to?
No, not really. No.
All right, mate. Well, thanks very much indeed, Robert.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay.
you feel like I do? Are you getting a feeling the Edge radio broadcast is growing? Well, if so, you're right. The Edge program has been hitting the bullseye of what people are interested in. Do you feel like I do? We're now broadcasting 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, from the new EBN, the Edge Broadcasting Network. We've added a web store. We're making a difference in the search for truth, and we're sharing our success with you. Do you feel like I do? From around the world, people are listening. They're sending in their stories and comments. They're making guest suggestions. They're telling their friends about the show. Do you feel like I do? Listen every Saturday night, 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, and feel like I do, right here on this station.
Political and religious news, supernatural happenings, unexplained mysteries, conspiracy theories, and special guests along with your calls, right here on the Edge Radio Broadcast with your host, Daniel Ott.